know everybody been waiting on that baby, man. I mean, it like ever since baby on baby drop, man.
Ever
like,
since baby on know, baby
drop. Ain't nobody drop shit. Made another. Let's go.
What's good? What's good, YouTube? Your boy had to make a little quick video about this one. Nah, like I always say, do a pre-trip, but at the same time, Stevie Wonder could see something wrong with this motherfucking trail. On this side, you know, it looks very good. You know, it looks good. Now, dun, dun, dun. Look at this shit right here. Look at this shit right here. The damn trailer don't have a door. You know what I'm saying? They told me to goddamn grab this trailer and bring it back to the yard. The damn trailer doesn't have a door. You feel me? You can see another driver done tore the shit off. Look at this shit. They done tore off the goddamn door. And look at this shit. All these scratches and all that. God damn. Whoever had this trailer last could not drive. Look at this shit. They could not drive. Gee whiz, bro. I ain't never claimed to be the best driver in the world, but nigga, I could damn park a 53 footer. You know what I'm saying? 53, 20, 40. It don't matter. That's why I was thinking about doing a wide load. Go ahead and take the test, do a wide load. But god damn. This shit is ridiculous. This shit for the birds right here. Let's look at this shit. God damn. Then one thing I just noticed, you know what I'm saying? When I finally got back to the yard, turning my paperwork and all that kind of stuff, I talked to my DM. I was like, well, you know that trailer didn't have a door. It didn't have a door and it was all messed up, blah, blah, blah. It was a DOT compliant. And I was trying to finish off, it wasn't DOT compliant, but I still risk it for you. Cause I know you say you really needed that trailer and you didn't tell me initially that the shit was all fucked up. Before I even could finish, she was like, oh, I know it didn't have a door. Wait, the fuck? So you know my shit, and you know the damn trailer ain't had a door. So that means it's not DOT compliant. So that means if I would've got pulled over, I would've got a fat ass damn fine. Courtesy of y'all, that y'all gonna make me pay. Y'all ain't gonna pay the shit. Shit, even if they were to pay it, it's still going on my damn license. You know what I'm saying? I was trying to be nice because I was like, okay, I'm going to chance it. I was saying to myself, okay, I'm going to chance it. Since the place they wanted me to pick the 53 footer from, it was only like 3 miles up the street. So I say, fuck it. I'll go ahead and chance it. But goddamn, that shit blown. It blew the fuck out of me when she said that shit. So I know it was missing the door. I know it wasn't exactly DOT compliant. I said, you know what? I'll see you tomorrow. I turned around and I left. Because I almost about to curse her out like a damn dog. Because I'm like, so you know this trailer wasn't DOT compliant. But first of all, you didn't tell me initially. Second of all, you acting so nonchalant about that shit. Oh, I know it wasn't DOT compliant. See how the fuck damn DMs and dispatchers and all that kind of shit lie to you in your fucking face. You know what I'm saying? She could have easily been like, you know, I really need that trailer to be, you know, to come back to the yard, but it's not exactly DOT compliant. Do you mind hauling it? It's only 3 miles up the street. If you don't want to haul it, it's okay. I understand. Because technically it is against DOT. And you can get a ticket for it. She could at least have told me all that shit. Knowing me, I mean, it's only 3 miles up the street. I probably still would have took it. You know what I'm saying? It's not like I had to make good ride, you know, ride from like Savannah to Statesboro, or Savannah to Hinesville, or Savannah to, you know what I'm saying? Something like, some bullshit like that. I just had to ride 3 miles up the street. You ain't even, it's something like, I don't know, bruh. If you meet a person and you got, I don't know, no offense to nobody, and you got, I don't know, like, you got something. I'll say that. You got something. You should at least pull that person to the side and be like, well, you know I got so and so and so and so and so, but I'm taking my medicines, like, my medicine like I should, and it's not going to really affect you. it's kind of dormant. Blah, 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 blah. You know what I'm saying? That just, maybe it's a bad analogy, whatever, metaphor, whatever. I don't know. But you could at least give me that opportunity to be like, well, Robert, it's not exactly DOT compliant, but it's only up 3 miles up the street. So, I mean, I want it to back to the yard, but if you're not going to haul it, I understand. Her ass going to let me go all the way there, haul that damn trailer all the way back to the yard, and don't say a motherfucking thing. She know I'm so, like, I love money, so anytime they ask me to do something extra for some extra bit of change, I'm going to say yeah. I mean, it is what it is. I mean, I love money. I ain't rich by far. So, she probably already figured that shit. Because she probably said, Robert ain't going to damn turn it down. Robert love money. Blah, 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 blah. What's the saying? All money ain't good money. So, I could have got me a fat-ass fine with some shit on my goddamn CSA score. You know what I'm saying? That could affect me getting another damn job. A better job. So, it is what it is, you know. I mean, I learned my lesson. And I finally got some proof or whatever to, I can't really trust this company like that. A lot to you in your fucking face. Just to get a load delivered or get something picked up. So, it is what it is. Next time I do them a favor, it's because of me. Because I want the money. Because I want the money. And I thoroughly research the money. So y'all keep that in mind. Thoroughly research the shit. If your boss be like, oh, do XYZ be, you know, do XYZ for me. Okay. Think about it first. Be like, what's the pros and cons about it? If you're another truck driver such as myself and they want you to pick up a trailer, ask them details about the trailer. Is it in compliance? Does it work? Is the tires inflated? Is the trailer okay? Ask them damn questions. But anyway, I'm gonna holler at y'all. You know, y'all already know what to do. I can go get, gotta give me something to eat. Do something, bro. Like, for real, for real. I'm gonna holler at y'all. Oh yeah, that's right. I did forget something. That, yes, that was a part of my pre-trip. Always pre-trip your equipment before you start. That's like a duh moment. But, you know, just in case, you know, she just, all of a sudden, out of the blue, she's so thirsty about you picking up something, picking up a trailer or something like that. Ask a little quick question. Is it okay? Is it operational? Something wrong with it? See what she tell you up front. Yeah, yay, nay, whatever. See what she gonna say to you up front. See whether she lying to you already. Now, I didn't do that. She just asked me to pick up a trailer. I was like, y'all gonna pay me? That's the only question I was asked. Y'all paying me? That's really right. Robert, yes. You ain't doing nothing free. All right, then. I'll pick it up. But from now on, I'm gonna ask, is it a compliance? Is it operational? Is the tires inflated? What's the condition of the truck? Where is the truck? How long the truck been sitting? All that could determine factors of the condition of the truck. Truck, trailer, whatever. All that could be determining factors of the condition of the trailer. Everything I just named. But anyway, that's all I want to say. As y'all can see, I'm right now, you know, the little, you know, the construction zone, but I'm not going too fast. You know. But anyway, I'm gonna let y'all.